In my last video, I introduced Makita's impact driver and vacuum cleaner. They use the same 12-volt battery. Being able to reuse the battery is very convenient. But having only one is inconvenient. So I bought a Forbidden compatible battery. Compatible batteries are cheap, but you have to be careful because they are also dangerous. I bought three Whately batteries. It says 3 ampere hour and 6 ampere hour. I'll try to measure the actual capacity later. I bought this by saying compatible battery charger for compatible battery. It turns out that the cell balance goes wrong when charging with this charger. This may not be balanced charging. Therefore, I made it possible to use a general purpose balance charger by using only the terminals of the compatible charger. It runs on 12 volt, so you can charge it from your car's cigarette lighter socket. Here is the disassembled genuine and compatible battery board. Circuit-wise, they are exactly the same. I drew a circuit diagram. It should look like this. Both ends are balanced terminals, and the center is a temperature terminal. Here is the disassembled charger. The circuit scale is completely different. The decisive difference is that the compatible charger does not have a balanced terminal connected. The problem without balance charging is that the cell balance is out of order. Overall, the full charge is 12.6 volt, and the balance charge is 4.2 volt each. Without balanced charging, one cell may be overcharged. As a result, the risk of ignition increases. There is also a problem if the cell balance is out of order during discharge. Even if the discharge is stopped at 9 volt as a whole. If the balance is off, only one cell will discharge abnormally. As a result, gas is generated and the cell becomes unusable. Therefore, I connected a charger capable of balance charging to the balance terminal like this. This is what I bought to charge the battery of the drone before. It operates on DC 12 volt and can also be connected to temperature monitoring sensors. The battery type is lithium ion. Here, temperature monitoring is set and the stop temperature is set to 50 degrees Celsius. I tried to actually stop charging or burn the sensor. Stopped. First, attach the temperature sensor. The terminals are protected with insulating tape. Fix the charger with a glue gun like this. There is a fan on this side, so be careful. The other side is air intake holes, so do not block it. This charger also supports storage voltage. Used when not in use for a long period of time or when stored at extreme temperatures. It charges and discharges until it reaches 11.2 volt. It can also be used for discharge tests, so let's measure the capacity of the battery with this. I also measured the weight. Discharge is done with a start voltage of 12.5 volt and an end voltage of 9.6 volt. Also, the discharge current was 0.4 ampere. That's the limit of this charger. The genuine one has a capacity of 1.5 ampere hour, which is almost as indicated. The compatible ones are almost 2 ampere hour and 4 ampere hour. It's smaller than the stated capacity, but that's what it is. Finally, I will charge compatible 3 ampere hour. The charging current can be set freely, but this time I will try with the maximum current. It's charging at 4.3 ampere. This time, I'm charging while monitoring, so I'm doing it at the maximum current. Considering safety, I think it is better to keep it to 2 ampere, which is 1C charging. I was able to charge it in 35 minutes. Please subscribe to the channel, thank you.